Welcome to the most important day in the lives of Diadem and Miracle. Today, promises have become permanent and friends have become family. Today is a celebration and we are here to celebrate with Diadem and Miracle. A tale of love that promises to last forever. Today promises to be one of beauty, friendships formed, and bonds lasting forever. For you all who have come from far and near to celebrate, we hope you take joy home with you. The happiness of marriage is the highest happiness on earth. And this is what we've witnessed today. Sit back, relax, have the time of your lives. Thank you for joining us today on such a wonderful occasion. God bless you all.
hurt me too. Did you think revenge will make it better? I don't care about the past, I just want a love to last. There's a way to bring us back together. I must forgive you, and you must forgive me too. If we wanna try to put things back the way they used to be, 'cause there's no sense in going over and over the same things as before. So let's not bring the past back anymore. I never really loved her.
Love won't end. She's smiling like she used to smile way back then. She's feeling like he used to feel way back when they tried. But something kept them waiting for this magic moment. Maybe this time it'll be love and they'll find. Maybe
she falls in love, we let her go. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Thou art worthy. Thou art worthy. It's a day you have made yourself, very beautiful day, very bright day, very wonderful day, very glorious day. We thank you, Father in heaven, because it pleased you, you preserved our lives today. We worship you, mighty God, because known unto you are all your works from the beginning of the world. Little did we know when we started that a day like this was going to be, but you had it in your schedule and you brought it to come to pass. And for this, Lord, we say thank you, Father. Accept our praises in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
We are gathered here this morning at your bidding to celebrate you and to celebrate your work.
Yes, Father.
We thank you, Father, because you counted us worthy. We adore you, Lord God of heaven, for the families of Stephen and for the farm and Elujoba. We thank you, Father in heaven, because yes, you have planned this day yourself and you brought it to come to pass according to your will. Father, be exalted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
It's a day of joy, it's a day of rejoicing, it's a day of celebration. And as we are gathered together this morning to celebrate your glory in the lives of your beloved children, our beloved brother Miracle, Ifeanyi, and Lord, we ask that as we are rejoicing here on earth today, let there be joy in heaven. for them and for their sakes in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have started this work, Lord. Lord, we are asking once again that you facilitate it according to your will today and for the rest of their lives. Let it be a place of celebration as we are doing today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We have laid out our plans, our program here on the program sheet. Lord, we are asking that heaven will consent to it and stamp it with authority of acceptance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We pray, oh Lord God, that you will champion the day. You will take control of all that will be done here this day in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we are rejoicing for the establishment and for the foundation of a new family, Lord, we pray that this joy will not know bounds in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As different families and different people coming together to rejoice for what you have done and for what you are beginning to do now, we pray, oh Lord God, all the days of our lives and the days of these children together, it shall be a time of thanksgiving on their behalf in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We commit all the vessels you will use today to facilitate your glory into your hands. We pray, Father, everlasting God, Holy Spirit, we pray you will use them for your glory indeed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Fine-tune them, Lord, and make them worthy of your use in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And as you are bringing the families of Elijaba and Stephen together today, Lord, it shall be to part no more in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Bless their home in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Together, they will make the glory of God to shine in their lives for the world to see the greatness of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Bless and glorify your name, Father,
because we are your
children. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Aloko se oro wa tope abi ko tope se oro wa tope abi jope lo. So because of this, we are about to worship Jesus, the author and the finisher of everything. So please, let's just be on our feet as we worship the King of Kings. Let's be on our feet as we worship the Lord of Lords. The Bible says it is not by power, it is not by might, but by the Spirit of the living God. It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed. We are here this morning by the grace of God. So I want us to be in the mood of worship as we worship the King of Kings.
Hallelujah.
àjò ni. O lè gbàdúrà wípé ẹ̀rí ọmọ ò ní dẹkun lórúkọ Jésù.
Ó gbàdúrà wípé ẹni tó bá ti lè ṣe àmì. Ó gbàdúrà wípé orí olórí kò ní kéré iṣẹ́ oníkálukú wa ní orúkọ Jésù.
Okay? Because we know why we are here, so we have to go into the business. We are here because of D and M. Who can tell me the D? D is for? Hey, I can't hear also. D is for Diadem. And M is for? So we are here because of Diadem and Miracle. God will give us miracles in our families in Jesus' name. Two families are coming together. The families of Erujoba and Stephen. Praise the Lord. Because we want to know whether you appreciate the thing we want to give you today. Yes, yeah? Beautiful bride. Yes, so you have to face your in-laws. And they have come. You know what? I'm supposed to first go and ask. But I could see that even if Daddy and Mommy and everybody in the family, they are even so happy that I saw you already inside the house. I said, do I need to go and be asking again? So you are already accepted. Praise the Lord. You are welcome. So Miracle, where are you? Opa Iyawo, Abi Retire. Opa Iyawo. Take it out, go down.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, because of you, they brought plenty money. I'm giving it to Daddy in one month. They brought big box of clothes. They brought all this fruit, everything, top of it. Yam, oil, salt, rice, umbrella. When you give back on twins, I mean triplets. He does use an umbrella, eh? You do it to shampoo like that. Honey is there. When you want to drink tea, put honey. Banded yam. You don't need to carry the pounding, whatever. There is pounding machine everywhere, all over the world. Just fere with the best shoe. Your salad, yeah. Yes, today, because all these things are brought for you, but because you see the way you are dressed, you are. But I'll just allow you, just as a token of accepting to just take one out of all these things. Look at it very well. Which one do you want to take? Take what? What is that?
Bible.
You are picking Bible. Yes. That they taught them in children's church. Amen.
Your children, thank you for the husband and thank you for the wife. Thank you for bringing them together and thank you for your grace upon their life. Father, we appreciate what you have done. Receive all our praises in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Our God and our Father, these children, they are yours. They are starting a journey. I ask, oh Lord, that your presence we go with them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I ask, oh Lord, that their coming together will be a blessed union in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I ask, oh Lord, that you will cover them with the blood of Jesus.
Lord,
I ask, Lord, that as mountains around about Jerusalem, you will surround them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, I pray, no evil will befall any one of them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I pray, Lord Father, you will bless them with the fruit of the womb in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your glory will shine upon their lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray, Lord Father, there shall be no regret in this marriage in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Almighty God, all their heart desires, Lord Father, I pray to glorify your name, you will grant in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Whatever the enemy may be planning for them, I stand on the rock of ages. All other ground their sinking sound. I decree by the power and authority in the name of Jesus Christ, every power that is opposing, disturbing, hindering progress in life, I bind you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray, O Lord, that your glory will shine upon them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, keep them by your mighty power. They are coming together. Will be a blessing for every one of them and for their parents and even for the children they are going to produce in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We bless you, Lord, because you are fancied. Lord, I pray the rest of this program today take control.
Amen.
Let your name be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name, I have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, sir. Amen. Yes. Many of our father in Utoba, the groom's family and the bride's family. I don't want to stress you because I know you come from a very far place. So just bend down your head and say, thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. In appreciation. Abi is not, doesn't want it. So make sure you appreciate them so that they will be happy. Thank you, ma'am.
So, as I can go through, so, praise the Lord! So this is the family of Kede, is Ogunti family. So we have here the father, you already know him and you have seen him, Pastor Elujoba Samson. Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah.
The younger brother is there. That is Brother Kende Elujoba. And our mommy, okay, Ayodeji, you have seen her. And then behind there is the younger brother to your big-in-law, Mr. Emmanuel, and the wife, Elujoba. Praise the Lord. From this side, the pastor that prays for us is the husband to the senior sister. That's the senior sister there. This is Veronica. So this is the mother of your wife, Stella Sholakwe Elujoba. Elder sister, the one they born before, the first one. Now she sit down there. Now her name is Joke Adeniyi. The one way follow her. Now she sit down for back here. Yes, and the one we followed out might be this man, Femi, way there behind there. And the time when she dropped breast, now me carry her. So, that's how it be. Praise the Lord! And Tolu is there, is the son. It's now a grandson of the family. So praise the Lord.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Yes, you have tried. I want to introduce, this family is very big. He just introduced the immediate family. Now there is a big family here I want to introduce to you. When I sing this song, if you belong, you rise up and sing with me. Deeper,
deeper.
you. I've been taking care of the bride. It's brother. Please, Selu Joba. Let's clap for her. Another. William. Oloruko Pastor Kumuyi. Clap for him. God bless you in Jesus' name. Ina Adaba. Ina Shetilo for Jesu. So we'll celebrate you too in Jesus' name. You have anything you want to tell us?
I really appreciate your coming, friends and families from far and near. You know, we have people from Lagos and our family over here. That's why I really appreciate you. And I pray God will bless our union in Jesus. I'm really happy for her, you know, particularly she's facing it. She's experiencing a new phase in life. And secondly, because I won't always have her by my side anymore. You know, you can't barge into her room anymore. And she's going to start living in her husband's house, you know. From now on, you have to reach her on phone and then. Hope you are not taking care of the kids and you know that.
Thank you very much. God bless you in Jesus' name. Don't worry, the husband is taking her away. God will bring you your own wife too when it is time in Jesus' name. Thank you. God bless you. Yes, so it's now our turn.
Olujoba, I hear Kehinde. I didn't hear Taiwo. He's on the way. Okay, he's not here.
In the next few minutes, you will see Taiwo.
Thank you very much.
Yes. She left Lagos this morning, and I believe she's in heaven.
So that is your
first. She's alive.
That shows that I am very, very observant. I was taking my time to listen to the names that was mentioned here. Oh, you know who? You're invisible. To the glory of God, as the MC has earlier said, we are from Amike, autonomous community in Olu local government of Imo State. We know how to do it. In fact, what I was saying here today is just a preamble. When the time comes, mommy, let me show you how to do it. We don't need that. By grace of God, we grew under elders in Lagos, and we understand how to double it. The man on Agbada White, you know, because we are here, that is why we want to dress like you, so we look like you. He's the father of the group. He is Mr. Samuel Ogwei. That's the father of the group. Miracle Stephen. You see, you might hear Ogwei here mentioned now as Stephen. The Stephen is the name of his father. The name of his father is Stephen. Why we had mentioned the name of his grandfather? So he was answering the name of his grandfather. But when he now gave birth to his children, he said they should answer his father's name. That's why you are hearing that. That's Stephen. So this is Mr. Samuel Wayne. This wonderful man you see here, always laughing and taking
care.
This woman you see here, I know today will be her happiest day in life because it's a day she will never forget in her life. Whenever she look at that boy or that man that is called Miracle, she gave that man Miracle for a reason. Time will not permit me to go into details, but there's a reason why you hear that name. God did a wonderful miracle for her. And I know she's over happy. In fact, she's the most happiest woman being here. She is Mrs. Ngozi Ogwei, the mother of the group. Mm-hmm. On the extreme here, you know, when you are going for a marriage and don't marry elders, you never start. When you go marry wife, you never carry elder before. In fact, your in-law will say, this one, and this is the people, the good. The good very well. The man you see here is, by the grace of God, Elder Israel Okwe.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You happen to be elders among the siblings. So he's the immediate senior brother to our dad. This auntie you see here is a wonderful woman. She's my elder sister. My mother is your elder sister. My mother senior, this elder here. So you can imagine how old my mother is. She's senior to this elder. Then this one now is not senior to this one. So my mother, this is our first fruit. She's Ngozi Ekwueme, the wonderful woman. This young man you see here, I don't need to go too much. He's a junior brother to the miracle. They are only three. By grace of God, God does give them only three boys. Or three army, as he has specified them. So he is last born of the three. He is Mr. Stephen Victor.
Praise the Lord.
This one you see also here. Don't look because he's a little bit smaller than this. He is the immediate senior to him. Immediate senior to him. His name is Mr. Emmanuel Stephen.
Praise the Lord.
I will introduce you before I go to my organ. This wonderful woman you see is a woman, I will call her a gracious woman, Abigail. A gracious woman. This is my immediate elder sister. This auntie is senior to her. She's a wonderful woman, and God has used her and has been using her and is still using her. In fact, the birth of miracle, she played, God used her to play a major role before miracle was born. So her name is Mrs. Ifeanyi Akame. And the extreme is my in-law, the husband to this wonderful woman. By the grace of God, he's a minister of the gospel. He's called Bishop Emeka Akame.
Praise the Lord!
His son, Oyedekachi Akame. My second daughter. My name is Sophia Akame. Our last born, her name is Judith Ekwe. Wonderful woman. This should be our last born, but somehow something happened. We now have another last born. So she is Mrs. Ndidi. When you hear the special, Orisakwe. This wonderful woman here, you see, when you live in an area and you don't make friends or you don't live a good life, your neighbors will not want to identify with you.
a very good neighbor. Mama Tide, as she formally called, she heard of this occasion and she said she would be with us in this occasion. And that is why she's here.
Amen.
I want to assure our daddy and our mommy. We are meeting for the first time yesterday. We talked about it. I know as women, you will be like, my daughter is going to the States. It's too far. Ojino. But with God, it's not far. This damn self, I call her damn self, that God has given us this day. You will never regret ever. In fact, you will give a testimony of what God is using her to do in our family. She's in a safe hand. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, by the grace of God, God will use us and take care of her. I want to also tell you, mommy, now you and I, we are one more, we live more. With time, we will still invite you to our place. I hope you will come with all of them to our place. Our daddy for
you. I like it.
This good thing that God has started between the two families
the family of the Elujovas, the Stevens. It will be a very worthy relationship that will withstand the test of time in Jesus' name. I am supposed to share with us briefly from the Word of God, and it is called a short exhortation. So I'd like to take this, before I do that, please let us have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you because this is your doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. You are the author of the institution of marriage, and your word said that marriage is honorable in all. Father, we are praying that this will have helped us to do so far. You will help us to end it well in Jesus' name. And we know that marriage itself is a journey, not a destination. Therefore, we pray that as this our young couple commence this journey today, your hand will be with them. Your presence will go with them. And by the time they will get old, they will not have any cause to regret this union that has been established today in Jesus' name. Amen. Speak to us now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We thank God once again because we are here today, because Genesis chapter 2 has happened to Brother Miracle and Sister Diane. Here the Bible tells us that it is not good that the man should be alone, in verse 18. I am saying this has happened to this couple because I was privy to have listened to their testimonies. How one day, Miracle just felt, I need somebody to marry. And then he started looking around. One day, he came in contact with her. Then he said something inside him. He said, I've been seeing Christian ladies before, but this one, there's something special about her. Then he started observing her. Then one thing led to the other. And today, as they used to say, the rest is history. The sister also, when she got to know that somebody was praying and somebody was feeling led of God, she too, she went to pray. And at a point, she came back and told us, it's like after praying, God said, that is the will of God. And that is why the church today is involved. And we are so happy that we are part of this history that is being made. Now, if I read further in Genesis chapter 2, in verse 18, it says, and the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make therefore a help suitable for him. In verse 19, and out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air, and brought them unto Adam to see what he was going to call them. And Adam gave every animal, every beast, he gave them names. And at the end of verse 20, and the Bible says, but for Adam there was no help suitable for him. God brought in verses 19 and 20, to see whether Adam was going to choose by himself. But Adam did not. He waited on God. And that is exactly what he reported. When he was in Ukraine, he saw a lot of ladies, Christian ladies, but he said, the day he set his eyes on this lady, he felt something special about her. Then he started feeling, it's like God is telling me something. He subjected it to further prayers, and God said that is the will of God. Now you can imagine the way God works. All the way from Imo State, they couldn't find any in Anambra. He traveled further, he couldn't find any in Delta State. He came to Edo State, then he crossed over to Ogun, and eventually he landed in Osun State. And God said that is the place. Don't you see God is wonderful? And before he got to Ife, he passed through Ondo. That's where our mommy came from. Then he said, no, you have not yet arrived where you are going. And then eventually he arrived at Ife. And God said, now you are there. So this is something God does. Marriage is a mystery. And the Bible says, blessed are they who find it in God. Many of us sometimes we are tribally sentimental We say I must marry somebody from my place, but in God's economy, it is not like that. And that is why when you pray, God will lead you. So I want to talk to our young people that are here today. You are believing God for a day like this in your life, please make sure you do it in God. And when you do it, wait on God. God will lead you and you will get the bone of your bone and the flesh of your flesh. By the time that miracle happened to Adam, you saw what he said in verse 23. And Adam said, now, this is the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Today, I notice we are very, very conscious. We are very, very mindful of who we want to marry. We set up standards for ourselves. We set up a criteria that that woman must fulfill or that man must fulfill. Some of those criteria, if you look at them, some of them, he must have a house, he must have a car, he must have a this, and he must have a that. At the time Adam married, he had none of those things. But God gave him the flesh of his flesh and the bone of his bone. And the Bible said he went in unto her, and the two of them were both naked, they were not ashamed. Anything you do outside the confines of marriage, that is, it is called immorality. It is called adultery. It is called fornication. I would say that today in our society, because there is a kind of deviation from the original plan and purpose of God, we have a lot of evil going on today in our society as a result of this deviation from the standard that God had established. When Adam and Eve were together, everything was open. There was no secret being kept because the Bible said they were both naked and they were not ashamed. And they lived such an open and transparent life. And the Bible said Adam left his father, he left his mother, so that he can cling unto his wife. They were not always running to daddy and mommy to seek for advice. They were not always going to report her, daddy, something happened today between me and my husband. No. They were left alone. And thank God at that time there was no father, there was no mother. God was their father, God was their mother. So this, in the case of this, our young couple, they are going to soon start living together. They are going to start learning about one another afresh, because the period they spent in courtship is not enough for them to have known everything about each other. So they are going to be like a child learning to walk. They will walk, they will fall down, they will rise up. And I want to counsel, as you are doing that, please know that the Bible you chose today is your guiding principles. So don't always call daddy, daddy, my husband didn't give me this today, he didn't give me that today, tomorrow. No. And then miracle too should not be calling home in Imo State, and we say, you cannot come from Imo State, come out and be sending quarrel every day. So allow them to fall and rise is an experiment. With time and with the Bible as their guide, they will stand on their feet. And their marriage is going to be solidly built upon the rock, Jesus Christ. It will never be capsided by storms of life, by temptations from the devil. The devil will not have victory over them in Jesus' name. So what they need from you at this time is prayers, continual prayer, counseling from your wealth of experience. Give them counsel and then God will help them. They will hear the word of God, they will heed your counsels, and their marriage will stand strong in Jesus' name. Now the Bible tells us, now to all of us, that marriage is honorable in all and the bed undefiled. God instituted marriage so that we can, through marriage, procreate and raise godly seeds, thereby raising godly communities, godly families, godly communities, and godly nations. But today, the problem we have in the world is because there has been failure at the level of the family. If we do not bring up godly children, we do not bring them up in the way of the Lord, they are going to go into a society. They will marry people like them. Then, before you know it, they are raising up vagabonds, children that will become nuisance to the communities at large. I pray God will help us. The family we are building today, thank God, it is a godly family. The sister knows God, she found marriage in Christ. The brother knows God, he found his marriage right in the will of God. So, we assure another home is being formed today on this solid foundation of Jesus Christ. But for the rest of us, maybe we are married before now, we are all here married or we are not yet married, let us know that marriage was instituted by God to perpetuate holiness and righteousness in the land. It is in the family we can raise up children. It is in the family, when those children now go to school, when they go to other places, they will be able to continue propagating that good values you have imputed in them. And then today, the reason we are having waywardness in our society is because we have thrown caution into the wind. We have neglected the essence of marriage, to come together to build a godliness. That's the essence. And then to have pleasure together, to protect one another from ungodly influence around. It is in the marriage you can find fulfillment in all those things. It's in marriage you can find pleasure between husband and wife, intimacy. It is in marriage you can find wholesome communication. It is in marriage that you can find productive labor that will bring forth and then you multiply. But when we are not married, these things will not come to pass. So I want to advise our younger generations, our younger brothers and sisters, what is happening today is a joyful thing. I believe God can do it for you too if you learn to wait on Him and look up to Him and not look around and make your choices based on sentiment. You meet a lady in school because she's fair, because she's tall, because she meets your criteria. You jump into conclusion, then you go home and say, "Daddy, I like that girl." That was a mistake Samson made in the Bible. He saw a lady, she was beautiful, then he went home and told his daddy, "I found a lady. Get her for me, for she pleased me well." But we all know the end of the story. Number one, he lost her. Then number two, he lost his life. Number two, three, he lost his ministry, his purpose in life. He could not fulfill it to the full. Why? Because he made mistake at this point of marriage. So as we celebrate today, the union of Miracle and Diadem, I want to congratulate you once again, and I want to assure you, you are embarking on a journey that is going to become a terror to the kingdom of the devil, because yours is a godly home. And the devil is always afraid when he sees us setting up a godly home like this. So I want us to take you from them. One thing they have going for them is, number one, they are both born again, and they found and established their marriage in Christ. And that is why, by the grace of God, I have no doubt in my heart that theirs is going to be a very successful union. And very soon when we shall be hearing from them, we'll be hearing good things, testimonies. They will not be coming to trouble you that they don't start again, it will not happen in Jesus' name. They will only come to say, "God has done it. God has done another one. God has done it again." Good testimonies, because God is a third party in their marriage. And I pray that which we are doing here today, it will be a thing that will last and stand the test of time. And as many of us as are looking forward to a day like this, that God is going to bless our own children also, I pray God will bring it to pass very soon. Let's tell our children to look up to God, to wait on Him, and He will bring it to pass. Now finally, I made reference to the book of Hebrews chapter 13 in verse 4. The Bible tells us that marriage is honorable in all. So what we are doing here today, God sanctions it. He is interested in it. In fact, He delights in it. The first miracle Jesus performed when He came on this earth is the miracle of turning water to wine in the marriage at Cana of Galilee, where He personally participated and demonstrated the first miracle recorded in the Bible that was performed by Jesus. This is telling us that God is interested in marriage. But if in the area of marriage, in your own case, you have failed, God is still alive, He's still here today. He has done it for these our brothers and sisters. He can turn your bitter waters of marriage to become sweet. Very, very easy. He said, womangers and the adulterers, He is going to judge. So if you have been having perverted relationship, this is the time for you to trace your steps. Having relationship to anybody that is not legally married to you is a sin in the reckoning of God. And God is saying, He is going to judge it. But today, you can retrace your steps turn away from your evil ways. The unmarried people that are becoming girlfriends and boyfriends, they are sleeping with each other. That is called fornication. And the Bible is saying God will judge it. What are you supposed to do if you are in that category? It's very simple. God is a merciful God. Today, if you can repent and turn away from that rough, wayward lifestyle, God can forgive all the sins of the past. And then we give you the power to go and sin no more. There are people who are married, but they go outside their marriage and still commit immorality with strange fellows. The Bible calls that adultery. And the Bible is also telling us that God is going to judge people who are sleeping with other people's husbands and other people's wives. So these are things that are very rampant in our society today. And God is saying we must turn around if we are going to experience the goodness of God in our life. Today we are saying Nigeria is bad. Nigeria is corrupt. This is where corruption starts. If all of us can keep ourselves loyal to our marriages, faithful to our union, I'm telling you, we had a better society. If you are faithful at home, you will be faithful in your office. You will not take public funds and spend them on yourself. So this is where it starts. And if we are able to take care of this, I'm telling you, we will be able to find it. We will be able to live godly lives in the public place. And in this way, we will be able to have godly families, godly societies, godly nations, and then we will have God involved in our situation, and Nigeria will be better. So I want us to close our eyes as we go to God in prayer. We will start by thanking God for what He has done today in the life of Miracle and Diadem. Let us pray. This union will be blessed by God. This union will be established by God. Satan will have no part nor lot in their marriage relationships. Let us pray God bless. He will uphold them. He will keep them by His mighty power. And then let us now also pray for all of us that are here. I want you to commit yourself unto God, that God will make you a faithful husband. If you are already married, God will make you a faithful wife. And make your home a successful family that is going to raise godly seeds for God and for God's glory. Pray for your children, that God will raise them up. A day like this will come in their lives. We will also gather to celebrate them because they got it right. God will sanitize our lives and make our lives better. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we thank you once again for the united together of two families, and particularly of Brother Dade, upon Brother Miracle and Sister Dade. We know this is your own doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. We are asking that which you have begun, you will also perfect until the day dawn in Jesus' name. We pray the remaining things we are still going to do, the white wedding itself, the reception after now, we are praying that everything, your name alone, will be glorified. We pray for this family you have set up today. Satan will not be able to cause their ship they are traveling in to capsize in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We pray that distance will not be a barrier to their relationship. And as they enter into this journey today, you will see them through to a glorious harbor in Jesus' name. And I pray for everyone present here today, especially those who have seen their lives, that their lives have not been right with you. And they are saying, God, we are sorry. I pray, dear Lord, you will forgive them. You will wash them with the blood of Jesus. You will cleanse them and make their names to be written in the book of life, so that they can trace this day, 7th day of the month of October 2022, to the day they made peace with God. And I pray the peace of God will begin to abide in all our hearts and to be multiplied in our families in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, because we know your answer. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you blessed?
Yes.
I am blessed.
Yes.
I am blessed.
Yes.
Our blessings will be permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A church that is anchoring this program is Deeper Life Bible Church. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When I came,
Amen.
So we want to do the closing prayer now. come and give us the closing prayer.
Shall we close our eyes for prayer? Father, in Jesus' name, we are grateful to you for this great occasion. We thank you because you are the Alpha and the Omega. Thank you for the wonderful way in which you have brought this our sister and the husband together. Be exalted forever, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray that you use them as a point of contact to others that are believing you for something glorious like this. Answer their prayers too, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This new family, they are blessed. They will go from strength to strength.
Amen.
No weapon formed against them shall prosper in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The grace of God, the glory of God will cover you continually in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Thank you because you have answered our prayers. As people will be traveling to far and near places, I pray you give everybody journey mercy.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
So we are brought the program to close now. The naya you are asking for has come. Taiwo Kende. Welcome. This is the Taiwo of the Kende. And that is another daddy there.
I said, you have to do the picture.
Yeah,
I'm
sorry.